Yo, what's up, you guys? Welcome back to the channel. So as you can see, my FP manifold finally came in. I'm about to go ahead and install that. But first, I got to take off all my stock parts off the GSX because I ended up on getting state ref. So pretty much, I made an appointment and everything. I went, but I put all the parts off this one. I put it on the black one. As you can see, I have everything off right here. The whole exhaust, intake, intercooler, and everything. But the dude ended up on failing it. The call was actually pretty nice, just that as soon as he seen I have a manual boost controller, he told me that he couldn't even put it up on the machine. I would have to go back another day.
3 weeks later.
All right, so after they failed me, I tried to make another appointment, but they had a 2 month waiting period. So I wasn't trying to wait that long. So I went out of state and I got the car registered there. So I should be getting the tags in the mail probably like the next, like they said 7 to 10 days.
I also just picked up this carbon fiber hood. This is a Carbonetics AB version 2. I already ordered the hood pins, so I'll make an install video as soon as those get here.
I already put everything back on. I just need the whole exhaust system, the seats, and the steering wheel. Alright, so I'm gonna start from the front. So I'm gonna take off the manifold and then work my way back. Alright, now that I got the exhaust manifold off, I'm gonna take off the O2 housing. It's 3 17mm bolts and this O2 sensor. Exhaust on now, just that I lost one of the middle hangers, so it's hanging a little low right now, so I'll just deal with that shit later. So I was doing some research and I saw that people in the forums were saying that their car runs really hot with the FP manifold because they don't have a blanket for it. So Extreme PSI sells this heat shield, so I bought it. Hopefully it helps and it doesn't run as hot. I also bought new hardware because the stock bolts won't work for this manifold. So before you put in the hardware, you have to put this bracket in, and then this one right here before the bolt as well. That's what holds the shield. All right, so I just tightened everything back up. I put the brackets here for the shield. So you can see it has three little hooks, and the shield also has them right here. So those go in like that, and then this is the bottom bolt that goes right here. So it's just supposed to slide in like that. So yeah, after you slide it in the hooks, you just line this little bolt up on the bottom. All right, so I got it bolted up now. That little bolt on the bottom was giving me a hard time because it wasn't lining up at first, but I got it on now. It honestly looks way better than what it looked like, and hopefully it performs better because my car was overheating on the freeway. So as soon as I would go like 60, it would start overheating. So hopefully this lowers the temp. All right, so now I'm gonna change the steering wheel and then I'll put on the seats. All right, so I already disconnected the battery to take off the airbag, and there's 4 10mm bolts back here. I'm gonna take those off and then take off the 14mm right here. So normally you would have to disconnect everything, the horn and the airbag, but my shit ain't even connected, so. All right, so it's actually 17, not a 14. Finally got it loose. This motherfucker did not want to come out. All right, so the short hub goes first, and then the quick release. All right, I got the quick release on now. And I already got the quick release on the steering wheel, so pretty much it's done. There's my horn and that's it. I don't have the horn connected because I don't think it has power going to it. I've never used it for real, so I'm just used to it. So I already got the green GSX back from paint, and I also painted the wheels black. I already changed all the fluids as well, and I've been cleaning the windows with steel wool, and I've been taking out this tin, but it's taking forever because it's really old. And I've been cleaning the inside as well. I started cleaning out the carpet and I took out the seats. I picked up a new driver's seat because it was, the other one was kind of ripped up. So this is the one I'm gonna put on now. And this is the old one. So yeah, this one's almost done. So I just need to bolt up the exhaust, change the spark plugs, wires, and finish up these headlights. All right, so I'm gonna change the spark plugs and wires right now because I don't know how old they are. So I went with the NGK Iridiums for the spark plugs and the wires, I went with NGK as well. All right, so this is what the first spark plug looks like, and it's honestly really bad. Second one looks the same. The third one looks a little bit better. It's not as bad as the other ones. So this is what the fourth one looks like. This one's really bad too. So I usually put on these wires one by one so I don't mess up the firing order, but these already come labeled. I also just picked up this S13. This is gonna be my drift car. I've been working on it. It still needs a few things. I already ordered the Origin over fenders for the front and the rear. So when I got it, the car didn't even want to turn on, but it does have an RB20. I calibrated the TPS to 0.48, and I also made this little bracket for the throttle cable, and I changed the spark plugs, and I redid the wiring for the mass airflow, and it idles now, but the throttle still hesitates, so I still don't know what it is, because I don't really know much about RBs. I don't know if it's because it's on stock ECU, but it also doesn't have an adjustable fuel pressure regulator or a wide ram, so I do need to get that. So at first it struggles to turn on, and then the throttle just hesitates once it's on. See, it just turns off. Right now it's idling by itself right now. See, this is full throttle. So yeah, if you know about RBs and have any idea what it could be, just let me know down in the comments. I am going to be uploading more often now, so thank you guys for tuning in, and I'll see you on the next one.